All right, so in this video, let's use some checkboxes to delete rows. So what I'm gonna do here for this data, I'm just gonna add another column on the left and just add some checkboxes here. So I'll go under data validation, checkbox, and reject any other input, save, and I don't need this first one, so I'll just clear that. So at this point, I want to be able to just go in here and check whichever rows I need deleted from my data and run my script and take care of that. So one thing you need to keep in mind when you're dealing with deleting rows is that you have to be careful if I just do a duplicate, the way you go about deleting rows. Because usually when you delete rows, you're going to delete them by using the row number. Let's just go through a basic example. Let's say you just wanted to delete this empty rows. So that would be C8 and then 10 and then 12, right? So the tricky part here between these three numbers is how you go about deleting those rows. If you start deleting this from the top, you're gonna start having problems with this. So let me show you what I mean. So if I want to delete row 8, then I'm going to go here and delete row 8. And now at this point, if I delete row 10, see, that's not the right row anymore because we deleted the row above and this shifted. So now this row 10 is no longer the right row to delete. So for this reason, I'm going to undo this. When you do this sort of stuff, you want to go bottom up instead of top down. So what that means is that instead of starting from 8 and going to 12, I'm going to start from 12 and go to 8. And by doing this, if I go from this way, see, I'm going to start with 12 and delete 12. And then I can go to 10 and delete 10. And because 10 is above whatever I was deleting before, nothing is changing in this section, so I'm good. And then I'll go to 8 and delete 8 and see, it works out. So if I go bottom up, it works fine. If I go top down, then I have a problem. So now that we know this, let's do this with a script. So I'm gonna go ahead and do some checkboxes. It can be really any rows, even though I'm selecting the blank ones. So I'm gonna go to Tools and Script Editor. And what we'll do, we'll just, first of all, get a reference to this worksheet. So I'm gonna take spreadsheet app, do get active spreadsheet, and let's just save it in a variable SS for our spreadsheet. Then we'll get our worksheet. So I'll take our spreadsheet and get sheet by name. You could also do get active sheet if you wanted to get the active one, but I want to refer to this particular worksheet name, so my work. So that should get us the worksheet. Now this worksheet should have a method to delete row where you just pass the row number you need deleted. So to be able to use this though, we need the row numbers that should be deleted. And we're gonna get those by tracking these checkboxes in this first column. So what we need to do, we need to get this A column and everything in that and get which rows have the checkboxes checked. So let's just get the data from this column A. And for that, we'll take our worksheet and get the range. And I need the whole column A, so I'm just gonna keep it simple and do this. That should give me the whole column A. And for this, I'm gonna get the values from that range. So at this point, if I just do a console log of this, so you can see what's in it. So I'm gonna run this function. It's called my function for me. Now, when you run this script, you're likely to get a prompt to give permissions to run it. For me, I've done this before. I don't want to open a new project every time I do a video, so it's not gonna ask me. And what you're gonna see here, we get this array of arrays, and basically this first one is blank. Then we have all these falses, which are basically checkboxes that are not checked. And then we have this true, see, true, true. Those would be checkboxes that are actually checked. So now let's take this range of data over here and loop through it. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to loop backwards. Remember, because when we delete our rows, we want to go bottom up. So to do that, I'm going to do a regular for loop. And what we'll do here, we'll start with a variable. And initially, I'm going to start from bottom. So that's going to be this length, the length of the array over here, minus one, because array indexes start from zero. So if we have three things, let's say three rows in our spreadsheet, then this is going to go 0, 1, 2. So when we get the count of three, we're going to go up to two because we start from the second index. So that's that. I'm going to do then semicolon. And we need to keep looping this I until we get to zero. So while this I is greater than or equal to zero, we want to keep doing this. And then finally, we're going to decrement the I by one. So I minus minus. For now, let's just do a quick little thing. I'm going to do a console log. And what I'll do here, I'll console log two things. So I'll console log the I, which is the index, and I'll also console log from our array whatever is in that position I, like this. So we're going to console log the I here, and from this array that we get in here, we'll get in this I position, the item. So let's get rid of this console log and run this and see what we get. So just to show you here, see, I got 34 false, 33 false. And this false is in this array sort of structure, if you look here. Now, I want to get that false to just be false without this array structure. So what I can do here, I can just go inside of this, which gives me false in an array, and basically just get things in the zero index, which is the first item in that array. So by doing this, if I just save and run this, see, now I don't get those brackets because it's just the false. So now let's take a look what this does, right? See, it goes from 34 up to zero. Let's go take a look at our spreadsheet. See, in our spreadsheet, we get 35 up to 1. Remember, indexes in array start from 0. So basically, in the array, this goes like 0, 1, 2, 3. And this is going to be 34 instead of 35 because we start from 0 instead of 1. So let's just try to find the first one that's checked from the bottom here, right? We start from the bottom. Let's find the first true. There it is. See, it says 11th index is checked. And then 9th index is checked. So if I go check where is our checked box, see, that's 12 and then 10. Again, that offset of 1 because of that 0 index in the array. So if we want to basically match those with actual row numbers, what we're going to have to do, we need to add 1 to this I. So I'm going to do that and save. Let's run this again just to verify that this works. So now if I check my true boxes, see, I got row 12 is checked, row 10 is checked, and row 8 is checked. So 8, 10, 12. That's correct. Okay, so basically by doing this, we can say that this is going to be the row number, and this is going to be the actual checkbox, whether it's checked or not. So based on these two things, we can now use them in an if condition. So I can just say if. So I want to see if the box is checked. And if you remember, this right here gives me true or false. If it's checked, it's going to give me true. So I'm going to copy this and paste it over here. And then I can just check if it equals to true. Meaning if it's checked, Then we want to delete the row, right? And the row is going to be this I plus one. Now we're going to delete the row from this worksheet. So we'll take the WS and do delete row. And what we need to do is pass the position here, which is going to be this I plus one. So I'm going to do I plus one. So we don't need this console log anymore. I'm going to get rid of that. So with this, let's try to run and see what we get. So before we run, let's just check how many lines we have. So with all the blanks and everything, we got 15 lines. So let's just go ahead and type 15 here. So if we delete these checked boxes, which are three boxes, we should end up with basically 12 lines. Let's go check if that works correctly. So I'm going to take this function, my function, and run that. So that ran. Let's go check the results. See, empty rows are gone, and we got 12 rows total. Excellent. So that works just fine. So finally, what I'm going to do, I'm going to assign this to a macro so we can easily run it from someplace in here instead of going in the back end and running all of this from here. So we could create a menu, do all of this, but I'm going to skip doing all of that and do this with a quick method. So we'll just go in here under tools, macros, do record macro. And what I'll do in here, it doesn't really matter. I'll just select something and hit save and call this delete checked items or rows or something like that. So name the macro. You can also assign a shortcut if you wanted to. I'm not going to do that. I'll just hit save. And I'm going to edit the script. And what you're going to see here is we got to this. This is the code we wrote, but now there's this macros.js. And if I click in there, see, it's basically me activating that cell that I recorded with that macro. So I'm just going to delete those steps inside of that macro, go to our code, copy all the code in our function, not including the bracket for the function and the opening of the function, go to macros.js and paste it right in here and save it. And then go to code.js and delete all of the stuff from here. So now I have that in here. I'm going to close this. So what we can do now, we can just check whichever lines we need deleted. Go to tools, macros, and see there's this delete checked rows. And again, we can do this as many times as we want. And that should cover this. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.